Well, we begin this hour with dramatic developments out of Canberra, where Foreign Minister Penny Wong has signalled Australia could recognise a Palestinian state. The suggestion, breaking a long-held position by the government and setting up fierce debate with allies globally and Israeli supporters at home.
It's a hot one. Nine Federal Politics reporter Eliza Edwards is following the fallout. Eliza, she says it will help build a pathway to peace.
Yeah, Carl and Sarah, this could be a big diplomatic shift for the Albanese government. It currently does not recognise a Palestinian state, but overnight Foreign Minister Penny Wong used a speech to make the case for why one should be established. She says that it has the potential to strengthen forces for peace and undermine extremists like Hamas. Let's take a listen.
The simple truth is that a secure and prosperous future for both Israelis and Palestinians will only come with a two-state solution.
But with war currently raging in Gaza, the prospects for peace in this part of the Middle East are looking pretty dire at the moment. There is still a lot of tension as well in the West over whether to recognise a Palestinian state when Hamas still holds political power. The Zionist lobby in Australia has already hit out at Penny Wong's speech, saying talk about recognition would be seen as rewarding those intent on destroying Israel. There's likely to be plenty of other reaction today as Australia mulls this significant tone in shift in tone and formal position, guys.
Eliza, thank you. Welcome back. Well, Foreign Minister Penny Wong has made a huge call, throwing her support behind a Palestinian statehood in a move that could put Australia at odds with the United States.
The simple truth is that a secure and prosperous future for both Israelis and Palestinians will only come with a two-state solution. Recognition of each other's right to exist. A Palestinian state alongside the State of Israel.
Joining us to explain is lecturer of international relations at the University of Sydney, Dr. Martin Kear. Doctor, good morning to you. It's front page news headlines today, the announcement from Penny Wong. What will it achieve, do you think?
Well, I think it'll start the conversation in the international arena about what needs to happen with respect to the establishment of a Palestinian state.
Why is she coming out and doing this now, the Foreign Affairs Minister? I mean, this is a debate that's been raging for decades, as you know. So why now? What difference would it actually make?
Well, I think that the tragic death of the Australian aid worker has really given voice to Australian government's disquiet, intense disquiet, at what's happening in Gaza and Israel's persistent ignorance of international humanitarian law in what's been happening in Gaza. So the appointment of Air Chief Marshal Binskin to investigate or oversee the Israeli investigation of the killing of the aid workers, alongside this speech that is really a warning to Israel that there are ramifications for ignoring international humanitarian law and ignoring the international community's claims or desires for the war to stop.
The timing can't be seen as anything other than provocative. It just can't be seen as anything because both sides blow up now, but nothing happens.
Well, I don't think necessarily it's provocative. I think it's starting the conversation there towards...
But the conversation, as you pointed out, has been going for decades.
Yes, but now there is intense international disquiet about what's happening in Gaza. So this is not, I think, an isolated
Was it opportunistic
statement.
Then?
Opportunistic, yes. And seizing that opportunity to start to put this into the international arena. Various European states, I think, in the past have recognised the Palestinian state. And this is something that Israel has been fighting to prevent since 1948.
Is this likely to have an impact? I mean, you mentioned a few European states. You know, we're not naming any of them, right, because they're not necessarily having the impact, the desired impact. Is that what Penny Wong is hoping to achieve here? Because it seems as though, I mean, a two-state solution might be the only resolution in this ongoing violence, is it?
Well, I think the two-state solution, we need to separate a few things out. There's the call for the recognition of the Palestinian state. Then there's the actual, does that actually happen? Mm. Now, in my reading, an actual Palestinian state that is acceptable to Palestinians and the Muslim world would consist of the West Bank, East Jerusalem as its capital, and the Gaza Strip.
So it gets complicated.
And that will never happen.
They can't even do a ceasefire. Yeah.
Well, that Palestinian state will never happen because Israel will never give up control of East Jerusalem.
All right, so there's going to bang on and on and on again.
Yes, yes.
It'll make your lectures interesting.
Indeed.
Thank you. Welcome back. Foreign Minister Penny Wong has made a huge call on Palestine, potentially putting Australia at odds with Israel and the US.
The simple truth is that a secure and prosperous future for both Israelis and Palestinians will only come with a two-state solution. Recognition of each other's right to exist. A Palestinian state alongside the state of Israel.
Joining us to discuss today's headlines is National Senator Matt Canavan and Nine's Heidi Murphy. Good morning, guys. Nice to see you. Maddie, interesting timing. What's the fallout?
Well, this is all about politics, not about peace. Clearly, Penny is playing politics with the Middle East here because she and the Labor Party are concerned about losing votes on the Palestine issue in many of their own seats to the Greens. This is clearly not a serious attempt to deliver peace because there are so many complexities here, of course, about the creation of a Palestinian state, their borders, the issue of the rights of return, I mean, who the government actually is, especially in Gaza. This is not about trying to end this conflict. This is all about Penny trying to deal with the local political difficulties she's facing. And I think that's reprehensible. I mean, people are dying over there. I've been critical on this show of some of the actions that Israel has taken. But I want to see peace. I want to see us resolve this issue to stop people dying rather than playing cheap politics in our own country on the suffering of thousands of other people on the other side
of
the world.
I can almost see Penny Wong at home now because she watches the show, having a peppermint tea and spitting it out, saying it's nothing about politics. Heidi, Greg Sheridan, who's writing, I do like. You don't have to, you know, like everything that he writes, but he's a great writer. He says, Penny Wong has delivered an emotionally manipulative, substantially dishonest speech implying the government is on the brink of extending formal diplomatic recognition to the state of Palestine. Her reasoning inverts reality. Her facts are dubious, if not wrong. Her logic is missing. But this, the politics is compelling. Is it compelling?
Oh, look, I think as Matt's outlined, there's certainly some political things at play here that that go well beyond what really matters in this particular part of the Middle East. I don't think either side wants solutions put on them from outside the country. I think they know their own areas, their own issues, their own needs a lot better than politicians on the other side of the world trying to play to the base. Well,
that's
the local
my
front.
First thought was, why go in? Why go in
yeah,
there?
Why?
Knowing how hot it is at the moment is a story.
Only to play to the base, to calm some of the internal critics, external critics, and play to the internal critics who want action.
Australia has long advocated for a two-state solution but does not officially recognise a Palestinian state, and that's why the Foreign Minister's speech overnight will spark huge debate today. Penny Wong said the only way to break the endless cycle of violence in this fractured part of the Middle East will be when Israel and Palestine recognise each other's right to exist, and the international community must now consider the question of Palestinian statehood as a way to build momentum towards a two-state solution and put peace talks back on track. It follows similar statements from the UK, but will no doubt ignite backlash here. The Zionist lobby in Australia has already hit out at the speech, saying talk about recognition would be seen as rewarding Hamas for the October 7 attacks. Here was the Foreign Minister last night.
The simple truth is that a secure and prosperous future for both Israelis and Palestinians will only come with a two-state solution.
The Foreign Minister said that Israel's own security depends on a two-state solution, and she believes this will undermine the actions of extremists. There is currently an application before the United Nations Security Council for Palestinian statehood to be recognised. Now the question is, will Australia formally back that in, guys?